Hey guys, this is Nathan, and welcome back to TechNodeFirmaCraft. So, I am on my way back from a new member to the server's house. His game name is Bloody the Great, and he has been doing a whole bunch of exploring today, and he gave me a bit of a present here. So, he gave me a whole bunch of cinnabar and some cassiterite. And I mean, that is just great. That's stuff that I've been looking for. And, you know, that's the best possible gift that I could get right now. So, yeah, we're just going to be, you know, running this cinnabar through our machinery over here, get our maximum yield for that. And, yeah, obviously I've been getting squash. So let's see here if I can figure out which one of these chests I've got the cassiterite in. Ah, right here. Okay, so a little bit more tin, that's great. A little bit of silver there, too. So he said there was a whole bunch of stuff that he found, and so yeah, we shouldn't have too much trouble finding resources now. But we do have a bit of a problem here in the fact that we have virtually zero brine left here. So if we look here, yeah, there's almost nothing left. So I am trying right now to get some salt water down here. And I'm hoping that I have the ability to create an infinite spring. So I've already brought down one bucket. And I'm going to go ahead and put this second one down. But it seemed like before... Oh, no, no, no. Take two. So I'm gonna put this second bucket of salt water diagonal from the first one, and I'm hoping that this will create an infinite spring, and it looks like it has. So that is great. We should have an infinite spring now of salt water. Yes, that is great. So that will make it so much easier for us to Oh, because I already have four in my inventory. Okay. So now we can come in here and let's see here. Yeah, maybe I have enough inventory space. Let's go drop off the rest of that cinnabar in the enrichment chamber. And we should have tons and tons of redstone over here already. So we'll drop the rest of this in here. And yeah, there's a fair amount there. So I'm moving this over here. So I've got the redstone in here, I've got all of my compressed materials, and then I've got my osmium in there. So that'll be kind of a good way to keep everything sorted. So yeah, that's a pretty good amount of redstone, and we've got more coming. So now that we've got this infinite spring of salt water, now we can make quite a bit of brine. So over here we have a whole bunch of vinegar made up, and the rest of this is all rye whiskey. So we're going to have to be using, I think, our apples when they come in to turn that into vinegar. But so now we can take this and we can fill these barrels right here. So this is great. So, yep, I'll be able to get all of this brine back going here again, and get some of this food preservation going on again. We're gonna try to move a bunch of the food barrels over into the warehouse, and the warehouse, oh, I just took damage. Yep, my free runners don't have any energy left in them. But, so yeah, I don't have a roof on the warehouse yet, and I'm still a little bit short on the hempcrete. So I need to get, ooh, we got orange leaves already. Which type are these? Plums. Oh, that almost killed me. So, yep, I'm going to have to get these things charged up. I got to try to figure out what I'm going to use for the ceiling in here. So that's going to be a pretty big thing. And, getting all of this stuff stored up is going to be kind of important. Get it out of the way so that we can use the space the way that it's supposed to be used. So, yep. I'm going to get a little of that done. and we're going to come back in a little bit. Well, the apples got ready for harvest, and all I can say is, that's a lot of apples. Almost all of those are full stacks. We have one stack of red apples that's only 40 ounces, and one stack of green apples that's 59. So we can make tons of cider, tons of vinegar, or we can just pickle these apples and keep them for eating. So I don't know for sure what I'm going to do with them. Like I said, we have a bunch of this rye whiskey, so I don't know that we need to make more alcohol. But at the same time, I don't want to really waste a lot of vinegar in preserving these just to turn them into vinegar later. But now I have been moving some of the stuff here into the warehouse, and I've got a fair amount moved. So I've got all of the cherries, the lemons, the plums, the onions, carrots, sauerkraut, tomatoes, red peppers, and yellow peppers moved here. So I think I'm gonna just figure out what I'm gonna do with these apples, get that taken care of, and then I'll be back. So I now have almost all of the food stuffs moved into the warehouse here. I got the cheese in here. All of the vegetables are on this side, all the fruits on this side. I've got a couple of barrels here that are just empty vinegar barrels. And then over here, we have our pickled soybeans, but Dwaz calls them tofu, so we're going with tofu on that. Now, this wall here is going to be the protein stuff, and I just noticed I'm missing a block there. But this wall is going to be the protein stuff, so I still need to move all of the beef and pork up here. But there's still a little bit of stuff to move. There we go, grab a block here. But I've been thinking about what I want to put for the roof on this thing. And I think what I want to use is probably the basalt bricks. And, or possibly even basalt raw stone. Now the problem with that is I don't have a lot of the basalt bricks. And if we take a look at the map, the basalt stone, we need to go to the rock groups, or rock types, I think. But somewhere around here, I had found basalt. And I don't recall where, but I know it was quite a ways away. But somehow I'm going to have to find some basalt to do that. It's either that, or I could possibly go with, let's see here, if we look here, we want Railcraft. I think it's called Abyssal Stone? Yeah, Abyssal Brick. So Abyssal Stone, we can make that with any raw or smooth stone and ink sacks. So that's fairly close in color, and we might go that route. Let me see, how many ink sacks do I have? And we might just go that route instead. So I think those should be, well, they were in there. Dwaz moved everything around thinking that he was helping, and now I have no idea where anything is. So, no clue. I had them all in a chest that was right there. Well, that's annoying. Now, I could always just go and kill some more squid. Seemed to get quite a bit. And maybe I'll have to do that. But, so I'm going to kill a whole bunch of squid and come back, make some abyssal stone. I'll probably have to do a little bit of mining to get that stuff. But I'll get that, and I will be back. We'll take a look at what the roof looks like. So, to get my smooth stone, this is a pretty simple process. So, you need a chisel and a hammer in your inventory. Obviously, I have a stone hammer, so it doesn't really matter what you have for a hammer. These have to be on your hotbar. And, of course, the level of your chisel, it doesn't affect the ability to chisel, it just affects how long it's going to last. So you can see this block is highlighted in red. If I right click on it now, it turns it into smooth variant of what I want or what I have. So then I can go ahead and break these blocks, and all of them break off as the variants that they are. So I'm here in this spot to get the stone, because I also will be getting some coal here, and I've got a whole bunch of these portable tanks. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna drop this portable tank, and I am going to see, oh, I need the blue bucket for this. Darn it. Well, I was gonna pick up a bunch of lava and carry that back with me. Well, I don't have a blue bucket, so that won't work. So what I'm going to do instead, I'm just going to go ahead and dig most of the stuff off of the surface here and mine up some coal and get a whole bunch of smooth stone so that I can make a whole bunch of the abyssal stone. Now also, oh, there's a bear right here. But also there are squid down in the water here, so I won't have any problem with getting additional ink sacks, which I already have gotten 24. So I'm gonna gather up a whole bunch of this stuff, and I will be back in a little bit. So I've got a pretty good amount of the abyssal stone, and I also made up a whole bunch of these pine fences because I think I know how I'm gonna do the roof on this thing. So on top of every one of the brick pillars, I'm gonna add another brick and then go, whoops, not fall off. I'm gonna go a couple of these fences, and then we're gonna go up by one, but I guess it won't be the fence later. And then we're gonna go further again. And then we have, what is this, four of them there. So we need to come over here to this side. We're gonna go with four more again. So once again, I gotta not fall. I said not fall. Two, three, four. So that will, sort of. So those do need to connect. Okay, so I think maybe on the underside. And then we're going to take our abyssal stone and place that on top. So yeah, this is kind of going to look like a tarred roof, which is what it's supposed to look like. And then underneath it will look like we have support structures. So then the next thing is I will repeat the layer until I get to the next pillar. Now that one's going to run right into the middle of the door, and the rest of these pillars are not going to line up with these. So yeah, it'll look a little goofy on this wall, but this is what I'm going to do. Now the end wall, I'm not sure what I'm going to do there. I've got to look at a little bit more research images and figure out what I'm going to do there. Now the last thing that I'm thinking is on this edge here, I want to have some upside down stairs. And of course, like I said, I can't seem to get the recipe to work for making those bricks into stairs. I mean, we can look at the uses here. We're supposed to be able to take a hammer, and let's see if a stone, yep, stone hammer should work. Our red steel chisel should work. And if we make this pattern, I have yet to see this work. So, yep, doesn't work. And I don't know why, because it shows it as a working recipe. So, yep, I have to use the carpenter's blocks for that, but I want to have a lip going around the outside of the building with the stairs. That'll kind of hide the abyssal stone up above, but if you get further away, you'll still be able to see it then. But so, yep, I'm going to make that up and go all the way around this and put what I can on top of here. I'm pretty sure that I don't have enough, but I do have quite a bit. Now, one other thing, while I was mining up the coal, I got a full stack of coal blocks. So, yeah, that's a lot of coal. So, I'm gonna get all of this done, and then we're gonna take a look at something else that I'm thinking we need to do. Well, I've got the warehouse and the deli building pretty much finished here, and I think they look pretty cool. I did have to go back out and get some more of the abyssal stone, and I got a whole bunch of coal while I was at it. But if we come in here and take a look, we've got the pine fences for like support trusses, and then we've got the abyssal stone for the ceiling. Got a whole bunch of food stored in here. I went ahead and took my portable tanks and filled those with vinegar and brought them up here so that we can fill barrels with vinegar. And also I brought a better barrel with barrels in it to be up here. And I actually need to, I'll just eat some of these green apples. So I do have a whole bunch of green apples being pickled, some red apples and oranges. But we've got tons of food here now. Now we still need to work on getting some decor in here. I haven't quite figured that out yet, but we have just the regular pine plank fences in here, and the upper floor is just a hollow space. So I haven't used it for anything. It doesn't have any windows. If anything, I may turn that into a mob spawner, but I don't know. So we have this finished, aside from some internal decorations. And so now I would like to look at a little bit of something that's going to help out in the pickling process. And that is the solar evaporator from Mechanism. So if we take a look at Mechanism here, we have this solar evaporation controller, the valve, and the blocks. So the controller is kind of complex. We need a block of copper, some steel casings for mechanisms, a whole bunch of basic control circuits, and some glass panes. Now, I think we made these steel casings with the blue steel, regular steel sheets, and the hammer before. But the regular blocks, we get two of these from a ring of copper around a dynamic tank. Now, the dynamic tank takes the same steel sheets again with a cobblestone in the center, but that is not where our problem is going to come in. Our problem is going to come in these, the advanced solar generators. So in order for this thing to work, we need four of these to run it. So you can see we need four basic energy cubes, four atomic alloy, and these atomic alloy, I mean, they take the compressed obsidian on the reinforced alloy, so that's diamond and then obsidian. That's a pretty big deal. So then we have the black steel sheets, which we've made those before, and then these solar generators, which take solar panels, enriched alloy, black steel sheets, energy tablet, solar panels, enriched alloy, redstone, osmium, glass panes. So yeah, this is going to be a pretty big deal because we need 16 of those. So yep, I'm going to have to do a whole bunch of crafting. There's going to be a lot of smithing with the black steel, and I'm not entirely sure how much black steel I have at the moment. Looks like I've got 25 ingots. That'll last a little while. But now the reason I want to make this thing is twofold. First off, the evaporation, or the solar evaporator, makes brine. So I can take that brine, put it straight into a barrel, and use it for the brining process for pickling. The second thing is, right now we're tripling our ores. Well, I would really like to move to the next step, possibly even to the top tier of quintupling our ores. Well, to do that, we need to go quite a bit further. So if we go back here, we look at our, let's see here, I think it's the clumps. Okay, so right now we're running the clump, or the piles, through the purification chamber and getting a clump. Well, we can also take these clumps. Let's see here. Should say it here somewhere. How to get the clumps. It's not showing it. Well, we can take these shards and run the piles through the chemical injection chamber with salt, and that will give us shards. The shards we run through the purification chamber, and it gives us a clump. So that will make four. Well, we can go a little further and we can make the crystals. So for this, we need slurry in the chemical crystallizer to get crystals, and it'll make five per each. But how do we get the slurry? So we get that from the chemical washer with the regular slurry and deionized water. Well, this stuff comes from a chemical dissolution chamber with the pile and sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid comes from sulfur trioxide and water vapor in a chemical infuser. Sulfur trioxide is oxygen and sulfur dioxide in the chemical infuser. Well, the sulfur dioxide, we can make this stuff pretty easily by running sulfur powder through the chemical oxidizer. But we need that salt, and that's what we're going to get from the evaporation tower. This tower is a 4x4 multi-block structure, and yeah, it's pretty complex. The bigger you make it, the better it works, and it requires power and all kinds of other stuff. So I'm going to do a whole bunch of crafting. We'll get all the stuff together that we need to make one of those, and then we will see about setting it up. So guys, I've been doing a little bit of work getting everything ready to go here for the solar evaporation thing, and I don't think we're gonna make it today. So I went ahead and made one of these production tables from Steve's workshop. These things are really nice. If we look at we'll look at Steve's. So the production table, it takes a blank upgrade, three planks, and four raw stone with a steel saw. So the blank upgrade is a chisel and a hammer with some raw stone and planks. So not real bad, need a little bit of raw stone to do this. But the nice part is we have all of these upgrades here. So when we come in here, this thing has four spots where we can do things. And if we look at the upgrades, I have a crafting table in each one with extra storage. That allows me to do a little bit of extra stuff. Now we also have like the auto crafter upgrade, charger, production speed, input queue, fuel efficiency, lava generator, solar generator, auto transfer, filter, and transfer capacity upgrades. So there's a few of those that we could use. A lot of these are involving a furnace, which unfortunately we can't make a regular cobblestone furnace, so that doesn't work. But what we do have here, I've got a few things set up here, and we're not gonna go on to making the tank today. I thought we would, but we're not going to. So first off, we have the solar panels. And as you can see, I've got set up here all of the glass and all of the enriched alloy that I need, and I'm gonna have to put in more osmium and more redstone as I go. So if I shift click these in here, I need additional osmium and additional redstone. And so there we go, 45 of these solar panels. So we got just a little bit of stuff left there. So now we need energy tablets, and that's everything that I need to make all of the energy tablets for this thing. The thing is we are very short on black steel. This is all of the black steel that I have. I'm currently making some weak steel in the blast furnace, but yeah, we're gonna be waiting for a while on that. So what we need to do with that weak steel then, of course, is combine it with some pig iron, and then we can have more black steel, but I need a black steel ingot to put here, and then I need some more sheets as well. And also, we are very low on steel. I was hoping to actually have a full barrel of the steel, and we're running out. And I've got less than half a barrel of iron now. So, I mean, this is really being a drain on my resources. So, I don't know for sure what I want to do, but one thing that I do know is I'm not going to get this done today. So, I think I'm going to leave most of this stuff sitting here. I guess I can pull this out. But, yeah, I got the steel casings already that I needed. I need four of those for the, one for the basic energy cube, and then two here for the controller, and one for the valve. So, yeah, I don't know for sure what I want to do. But I know I'm going to have to go out and do some more mining for iron and a whole bunch of smithing. But I think that's going to have to wait for another day because I've been spending way too much time on this episode as it is. So I guess what I'm going to say is thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to give a thumbs up and let me know. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you next time. Bye.